Hello everybody, my name is Chef Joseph Shawana. Welcome to the Burnberry Farms Culinary Series, supported by the Indigenous Tourism of Ontario. So today we'll be making a pan-seared elk with a wild plum gastrique, with some peaches, some sweet plums, and some nice wild plums. These are very bitter. And we're just going to garnish it and finish it off with some spruce tips that we harvested this spring, as well as some wild ramps, or wild leeks, as some people may call it. It has a flavor of onion and garlic all mixed together. So today we're going to start off by seasoning the elk. So this is a nice elk strip loin. It's very low in fat content. So we're just going to season it with salt and pepper on both sides. Get your pan on medium heat. Add your oil. And while this is going, I'm just going to talk a little bit of the history that I was taught around how we're preserving our culture through food. A lot of people think that indigenous food is just bannock and tacos, but it's more than that. It's living off the land. It's living off your local terroir of your own surroundings. So growing back home, I never knew that we used to eat these. Long ago, we thought they were just weeds, so me and my family would just pick them out of the ground and just shuck them. It wasn't until I moved to Toronto until I realized exactly what our food meant to our people. These wild plums as well, like we would just, me and my cousins, we would, and friends growing up, we would just put them in our slingshots and just throw them at each other, because the seed is just, it's a fairly big seed. So, and you, kids being kids, you would just try to injure each other as much as possible. So, and it's always fun, and in a good way. So now that your pan is slowly, is heated up, I'm just gonna add your elk. You're gonna go for about 2 minutes on each side, just until it's golden brown. Yeah, and while this is slowly going, we're gonna start adding our other ingredients in there, so your wild leeks. So you're gonna go for about 4 wild leeks in each one. And this will give it a lot of natural flavor. So my cooking is very simple. It's straightforward. It's to the point, right? So you want to taste the elk. You want to taste the leeks, as well as the sweetness of the plums and the peaches. Just a little bitterness of the wild plums and the floral notes of the spruce tips. So you're just looking for a nice golden color, just like so. And you can see the wild leeks are getting nice and caramelized. Natural sugars are coming out. And at this point, you're just gonna add just a few pears, the plums. Well, go for about 4. And this is pretty much a one pot and one pan recipe. So, gonna add your peaches. So I tend to cut my peaches a day before and just add a little bit of orange juice or fresh orange zest into it, so they don't turn brown, but you get all the flavor that you would need from them. So just quickly give your plums a turn. So all these natural sugars and natural acids from all these ingredients in here is going to flavor up the elk. So you're just looking for like a nice medium rare finish on your elk. I'm just going to add your spruce tips. So, and your wild plum gastrique. So what I did here, I cooked off the wild plums in just a little bit of maple syrup and just reduced it, and I de-seeded it, and I just mixed everything in. So you still get the nice texture from the plums here. We did smoke the plums in our smoker. So I'm just gonna add this guy to the plate. And what this is going to do, it's gonna deglaze the pan. It's gonna get all the flavor off of the bits and pieces from the elk. So all of this brown stuff here, let's try to scrape that off. That's where all the flavor is. While this is reducing, you're just gonna let it rest for about 30 seconds. And while this is just reducing, I just need to mention that back home, we're working on a whole new initiative where we're going to create a whole culinary space for Indigenous culinary tourism. And myself, being the chair of the Indigenous Tourism of Associated Nations in Canada, our initiatives is to create culinary tourism based around Indigenous cultures and storytelling. So what that means is, like, we're going to be creating a whole culinary space that's geared towards how do we used to eat pre-contact, meaning pre-colonial, before European times, as well as how did we harvest, and how can we teach our kids and the general public who's coming in to the culinary space. So that should be in operation by spring of next year, 2021. That's one way that we're giving back to the whole culinary scene and culinary tourism in Ontario. So while this is nice and rested here, so I'm just going to grab the garnish. So of the wild plums, wild leek. So you're going to get a lot of different flavor notes out of this. So the bitterness of the spruce tips, the sweetness of the maple syrup, and the nice floral notes of the peaches. So now that the elk is nice and rested, I'm just going to grab a knife and just slice it just on a bias. So you're looking for a nice, rare, medium rare. When you touch it with the back of your finger, it should be nice and warm. You don't want to overcook any lean meat like this because it will just get too dry, and dry meat is never too appealing. And then just feel free to arrange it any way you feel. I tend to go all over the map with this just because you get a little bit of bites of every single piece in the meat. And then we're just going to quickly garnish with some more spruce tips, just add a little bit more green. And this plate really reminds me of home. For some reason, it reminds me of looking out the back door at my grandfather's cabin when we're out deer hunting or turkey hunting. So this is a pan-seared elk with a wild plum gastrique. So I'm going to grab a little bite of this nice elk. So just always make sure you grab a little bit of everything inside. Got all these memories coming back when I was a kid hunting with my grandpa and my uncles. So it's very subtle in flavor, but yet when you bite into your elk and you bite into all the other ingredients, all the flavors just pop and they just marry together. My name is Chef Joseph Shawana. I would like to thank Burn Brave Farms Culinary Series, supported by ITO, the Indigenous Tourism of Ontario, to showcase our food on a grand scale.